Hey Gunful fans, welcome to my very first video on my brand new YouTube channel. This is French Bread Builds here, and most of you guys know me from Instagram, and I finally decided to break out, make a video, get on YouTube. So the first video that I'm going to be doing is my first painted build, and that is the Master Grade Sinanju Stein narrative version. And before I get into the nitty-gritty of everything, I just wanted to make a huge shout out to my sponsor, Newtype HQ. They've got everything there. They've got kits, they've got paint, they've got tools, everything you need for this Gunpla hobby, they've got it all. So, shout out to Newtype HQ. Without them, I wouldn't be doing this right now. And so follow them on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, at Newtype HQ, and use my discount code FrenchBreadBuilds to get 10% off your order. So, with all the pleasantries out of the way, let's get started. So here we have it. We have the Master Grade Sinanju Stein narrative version. My first fully completed project, my first fully completed build, painted from the ground up. Well, 99.9% painted. The only things that I didn't paint on this kit were the beam saber handles and obviously the beam themselves, but that's okay. Before I actually go into a quick review of the kit, I just want to kind of talk about my rendition of this and what I kind of did to it and how I tried to make it my own. So, first off, let me give this a little spin so you guys can get a good look. So, there it is. Like I said before, I painted everything from the ground up. I actually made this a little bit more difficult for myself because most of the primary colors on this kit are a mixture of colors. Nothing, for the most part, is right out of the paint bottle. So I will post, actually, in the description, a full breakdown of the paints that I used to get the colors that I got. As you can see, it's not true to the original color, but I wanted to kind of make it my own a little bit. I went with a lighter gray for the main body. Actually, if you think about it, I kind of copied it, but I made every color a couple of shades lighter, except for the brown frame, which I kind of made a bit warmer, a bit redder. And maybe towards the end of the video, I'll actually show a picture of the before and after so you guys can get a sense of it. So I painted the whole thing, I painted the frame, I decaled it up with the Delpy decals that I absolutely love. They're great. It's a combination of the Sinanju Stein decals that they have, which have all those special markings that you can see on the shoulders and the side skirts and all that. I did the reverse wash for all of the markings, my very first reverse wash ever. And it came out pretty well, so I'm happy. You can actually go to my Instagram page, I documented the process, and you can see it. Maybe as I get videos together, I will actually show you guys the process and make a tutorial. But here we are. Okay, so now that I talked about what I did, how I did it for the most part, let's actually start talking about, let's talk a little bit more about the suit. So, and I say this all the time on my Instagram page and all of the lives that I do, that I am not a huge Gundam lore person. I don't know much about the lore, but I try to at least learn a little bit about the kits, the mobile suits that I'm building. I did watch the movie Gundam Narrative. I know that this Sinanju was stolen just like the red Sinanju was stolen. And they were originally all regular Sinanju Steins, and they were given the whole, you know, Neo Zeon treatment. And that's how they ended up the way they are now. You know, with all the markings and the darker tone. Personally, this is my favorite version of Sinanju, period. I've actually built the Verka in the past, and you can actually go on my Instagram page to see a comparison of the two. I built the Sinanju in the past. I have the red Sinanju in my backlog somewhere that I will get to eventually, but I'll be honest, painting this kit took a lot out of me. Verkas have a lot of parts. This is very complex. This is up there with Sazabi, New Gundam Verka, Hainu Verka. High part count. Makes for a very detailed build, but it also makes for a very long painted process. But I love the way it came out. I love the kit. The Sinanju is probably up there with the Jesta, the Masquerade Jesta, for being the most solid all-around kit. It's got everything that you would want. It's got detail, it's got accessories, it's got tons of posability. The only downside to this specific version is that it, if I recall correctly, it's the most expensive version of the Sinanju that you can get. It is very expensive. I think the box price is it 8,000 yen, which roughly translates to about $80 US after all is said and done. It is a pretty expensive kit, but that's because it comes with a lot of plastic. Lots of plastic. You can build, out of all the parts in there, you could build the full standard Sinanju. You can build, obviously, the Sinanju Stein narrative. There are tons of parts for extra weapons. You know what? I'll actually open the box. Here's the box right here, and you can kind of see the box art a bit. But I can open the box, and I can show you how much plastic is still, hold on. This is how much plastic is still left. So many runners, so many extra parts. It's good to have spare parts just in case things break, but there is a lot. So now that I talked about the kit, I talked very little about the mobile suit. I talked about how I decided to go with the colors that I went with for the most part and the decals and all that. Let's talk about the kit, right? And talk about what the kit comes with. So as you see here, this is the standard loadout. It has the, if you built the Sinanju Stein in the past, it's got everything that you've seen already. It's almost identical, with the main differences being the marking here and a different chest piece, the markings on the arms. What else? In the backpack, the only thing that is different is the length of the fuel tanks. The fuel tanks actually are exactly the ones that come with the red Sinanju. So that's cool. You know, you kind of have a little bit of both going on there. It's a great kit. It's a great kit all around. It's not a Verka in release, but it is a Verka in spirit. So let's go into something real quick. All right, so let's move this down. So here it is, right? You've got tons of detail and part separation here. I'm gonna be ginger with this just because I don't want to scratch the paint. Let's see. You've got tons of articulation in the backpack, thruster bells. Actually, the thruster bells don't move, but the arm that has them rotates and it moves and it pivots. The fuel tanks pivot. You've got a little bit of waist articulation here. You've got, and you actually can see some of the articulation there, but let me take off the shield. I'll get into the weapons after I finish the paint suit. I'm telling you guys, after you paint a kit, it's just like you want to be very careful with it, but at the same time, you don't want to be too careful with it. So, all right. You got your standard, I would say your standard Verka level articulation. You've got double knee bend. You've got the knee separation that everyone loves. I love it too. You've got toe bend here. You've got side to side pivot back and forth. You've got these thrusters on the side here. They come out just like this. You can, for the most part, hit a split. I'm being very, not trying to be too rough with it because I don't want to scratch the paint. You've got decent arm bend, very, very decent arm bend. You can go out this far. You've got this little flap here that moves out of the way. Very, very, very good articulation. Shoulders move out, and it's got that pull-out joint, get you a little bit of extra movement. Got some head movement here. Again, I'm not trying to do too much because I don't want to, scratch the paint that bad. So it's got a lot. It's got a lot of details, and I hope that the way I painted it kind of points it out. You've got this section in here that comes out. You can store a beam saber in there, which is cool. I actually got him holding a beam saber here. He has got those, what's the word? I don't like calling them 3.0 hands because that's not what they were called when they first came out. I believe they originated on the New Gundam Verka. So you've got the individually articulated fingers. You know, we all seen them. They had the tabs there. Really, really, really solid kit. I don't know how much more detail I need to go. It's a kit that you've seen before. It's not very different from the regular Sinanju Stein. But it is definitively the one of the best made master grades there are. I will say that. I've built a lot of master grades. I built the new Gundam, I built Hainu. I haven't built Sazabi, and I know I have to, and I have it, but I haven't built that yet. But this right here is probably one of the definitively best master grades out. It does everything right. It does everything right. And depending on how you want to dress it up, you know, like I did, I used a lot of markings that aren't really native to the Sinanju, but I use a lot of markings on mine. I love the marking look. I think this separates my build from a lot of others. But yeah, it's really nice. And some people, to hit or miss with the crest on the torso and on the arms, but I love them. Absolutely love them. So that's the main suit. Let's get into the weapons. There you go. So, these are the accessories. You've got a pretty decent loadout here. It's actually pretty impressive. So let's see what we got here. We've got a shield, we've got a hyper bazooka, and we've got a beam rifle. Starting with the shield, this shield is almost identical to what you saw with the standard Sinanju Stein. And the difference being that you have, first off, you have this point, which is not on the regular one, and you have this, not supposed to come off all the way, but you have this removable, looks like a, I like to call it a potato cannon. You have a removable grenade launcher, which is awesome, I believe. And it mounts right onto here for storage. Again, I'm trying not to scratch the paint, but stores right on there. Very nice, just the right amount of detail. I think my decals really did the shield justice here. Not too overbearing, but looks pretty nice. So you've got this, you've got the hyper bazooka. I actually took a lot of liberties with this. This thing came in that standard one color gray that was, I don't know, it was pretty boring. And what I didn't want was another massive gray weapon on this mostly gray suit. So I decided, why not match the frame a little bit with this? And so I painted some of these parts brown, and this, the rest are, I want to say it's Gaia Notes. It's Gaia Notes gunmetal, actually. Gaia Notes gunmetal. You've seen this in the standard Sinanju, or the Sinanju OVA, not the Verkha, I believe. You see this in the Sinanju OVA, and you see it with the Sinanju Stein. It's the same exact Hyper Bazooka. You can even see, it's hard to focus here, but it actually says MSN 06S Sinanju Stein. This is a Sinanju Stein decal, but I threw it on here because it looks pretty cool. So, and last but not least, you have the beam rifle. I also took some liberties with this. Added some of that frame brown in there, some gunmetal. I added some decals. It actually combines the Sinanju Stein beam rifle and the beam rifle of the regular Sinanju. It's actually the Sinanju's beam rifle is encapsulated by the parts here. So it looks similar, but it is not. And there are things this can do that the Sinanju Steins can't do. So, and I'll get into that, but it also comes with a fixed pose hand that is a lifesaver. It is a lifesaver. I love it. So, yeah. And I guess now I can show you probably the main reason most people got this over the regular Sinanju, the ability to combine weapons. All right, so it comes with two combinations here. You've got this plus the grenade launcher. Let's see if I remember how to do this the right way. Let's see. Goes in. Bear with me, guys. All right, there you go. Goes in here. Scratches the paint a little bit, but that's okay. Only on the connection points. So you can throw the grenade launcher on the bottom of here, which looks pretty awesome, but still not what everybody bought it for. This is cool, but this is not the coup de resistance, as they say. So you can combine it with the bazooka, which is awesome. You take off this part right here, shorten it. As you can see, I'm actually not scratching it. This is the perks of using Mr. Color Super Clear. Protects against scratches. There are some scratches here, but not too badly. So you can connect this, if I remember correctly, start here, and then plugs in, boom. And now you have this massive beast of a gun, right? So let's put it onto Sinanju, and you can see how he holds it. Since I just leave the hand plugged in because it's easier, let's take off his fixed pose, or his manipulators, and throw on the fixed pose hand, and voila. And no, he can't hold it, even with the paint. He does not do a very good job holding it, to the point where the shoulder is like popping off. But let's put this down here. You can see, you can get him in a couple standing poses. That's generally what I do. And it looks pretty awesome. Pretty damn awesome. So, that's pretty much it, guys. I mean, it's got the beam sabers, But, you know, once you've seen one beam saber, you've seen them all. And I'm actually kind of deathly afraid of moving this anymore and scratching the paint. But, yeah, guys, so that is the Sinanju Stein in a nutshell. It's an awesome kit. I think it's the best bang for your buck Sinanju anything that you can get. The red Sinanju is great. It's flashy. It's cool. But I personally prefer this version of the Sinanju over that. This is more grunty. And with the markings on it, it gives it a little bit more personality. So I like it. It's cool. It's a great project to paint, but you have to understand that dealing with a kit like this, the part count is high. There's a lot to paint. It's got a pretty complex frame. So those are some things you got to think about. But this is for sure, I like to call a builder's kit. If you enjoy building, you're going to enjoy building this. It's complex. It gives you that feeling of satisfaction. It's big. And it's a great kit. So next, I'm just going to show some B-roll. You know, I'll show some pictures of some different poses and maybe even a size comparison or two. Mostly with the Metal Club Kshatriya metal build. I love that. It's awesome. It's imposing, and it actually inspired how I went about detailing this. So yeah, guys, that's it. Thank you. Please subscribe. Please follow me on Instagram at French Bread Builds. Follow me on Twitter. You can search for French Bread Builds too. I think it's I think I have it as FB Builds on there. But yeah, guys, I appreciate the support. Thank you, New Type HQ, once again for empowering me to do this. Without them, I probably wouldn't be able to do as much as I do, post as much as I post. And I mean, even then, I just ordered this turntable here, and it's already made my life easier, because before I was using this one that came with my paint booth, and I had to turn it by hand, and it was ghetto, and it was janky, and it was about time that I stepped it up. So yeah, so head over to New Type HQ, use my code FrenchBreadBuilds for 10% off, and yeah, thanks for coming, thanks for stopping by the video, please subscribe, please share. I'm trying to do this even more. I'm trying to figure things out. Hopefully when I edit this and I cut it down, it's less than half an hour. So thank you guys, I appreciate it, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks guys.